Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1734, Price Table Lookup using Power Pivot. Well, hey, if you saw yesterday's episode 1733, we had a mashup data on the sold sheet, which has customer, item, and quantity, with a price list, which has a different price for every single customer. And I did that using a couple of matches and an index. I said I could have done it in PowerPivot. And when I posted to YouTube, Mike posted a note and said, hey, it would be interesting to see how you do that in PowerPivot, just as a comparison. All right, so yesterday we learned that the data was completely mismatched. The items numbers here didn't match the items across the top, but now we know that they're all exactly correct. So that helps. I'm glad that I went through the hard method yesterday using index and match, because that allowed me to discover all the mismatches. I'm going to add one more field here called key, and that key is going to be equal to customer ampersand item, and I'm going to use that to be the link in Power Pivot. All right, so we have our data here. I'm going to make this into a table with Control T. Click OK. I'm going to be a geek here and call this fact. That's what SQL Server guys call their main table. And under Power Pivot, I am going to create a linked table. So now that my sales data is in Power Pivot. Okay, here we are in Power Pivot. I can see that my display drivers the computer's probably ready to crash, but we're going to keep going anyway. We'll just return back to Excel here. All right, it's going to be a mistake, I'm sure. All right, this data, we have to unwind. We have repeating groups that are going across the columns. Those really need to go down. We're going to use the great Mike Alexander trick. If you don't know Mike, go to datapigtechnologies.com. So we're going to create an old-fashioned multiple consolidation range pivot table from this data, Alt-DP, multiple consolidation ranges, click Next. I will create the page fields, click Next. My data is here. Click Add, no page fields, click Finish. We get a brand new pivot table that is exactly like the original data. This is the point when it's ready to strangle Mike. It's like, what good is that? Well, what good is that you go to the grand total, and double click, and you get a table that is your original data, but it is unwound. Like this, Control C, Alt ESV to convert to values. This is customer, this is item, this is price. And then we still have our key field right here. So key is going to be equal to customer ampersand item. Double click to shoot that down. All right, so we don't even need this pivot table anymore. We can get rid of those columns, delete. And we will make this into a table, Control T, click OK. Let's call this price lookup or price table. Good. And we are going to add that to Power Pivot. Create a linked table. So now we have two items. We have fact and we have price table. I'm going to explicitly explain the relationship here. So we go from our key column on the diagram view, and I can simply drag from the key column in this table to the key column in that table to create the link. There we go. Let's go back to our data view and go to my fact table to create a column that is revenue. That is going to be equal to fact quantity times related. Related is like VLOOKUP in regular Excel, but we don't have to specify the whole bit here. So that is the price table. Times price, there we go. Okay, so related says, hey, just follow the relationship that I've already defined and go over and get the price for this customer, this item. We'll press enter there. It'll go through and calculate all of that. I'll right click and say rename, and I'll just call it revenue. Very good. Pivot table on a new worksheet, and then choose customer and revenue. And we are good to go. So without having to do a lot of VLOOKUPs there, it's a lot simpler to create the relationship in Power Pivot. Just drag from one field to the other and then use the related function, much simpler than using match and match and index. So there you go. Thanks to Mike for suggesting that I solve this exact same problem using Power Pivot. There was that extra step to take the price list and create that multiple consolidation range pivot table and then double click the grand total in order to unwind that data. The items that had been going across are now going down. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by For more about PowerPivot, check out my book, PowerPivot for the Data Analyst. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.